Hello everyone, in today's video I'm going to show you 10 Microsoft Word tips and tricks that will make your job much easier. So let's dive into the video to see these tricks. The first trick that I'm going to show you is inserting a text in Microsoft Word document at a specific point. Let me show you. For example, in this particular application letter, you want to insert a text on the right side, but as you press the enter key, it would automatically go to the left side. So in order to insert a text on this right side, what you need to do, you just need to double click at the place where you want your cursor to be. Let me show you. Let me double click over here. And here we go. Here you can insert "Yours sincerely, etc." If you enter, you can see it has again moved to the same place. So you can again double click over here and insert your text. While most of the people usually follow either clicking the tab key or space key to move to that specific location. Isn't it much easier? The next technique that I'm going to show you is how to select a particular text. There are many ways to select a text, but the one that I like the most is just keep your cursor over here, just behind the line that you want to select, and click over here. You can see with just a single click, you can select a line. If you double click, it would select the entire paragraph, and if you click thrice, it would select the whole page. Let me show you. You can see it has selected everything in the document. The next technique is removing the text from your document. Most of the time people just press backspace and delete the text by constantly pressing backspace. The short trick for deleting a text is just use Control and backspace. You can see a whole word is being removed. The next technique that I would like to share with you is how to clear formatting. Let me show you how this works. For example, I am going to write something over here in bold letters. Let me write. And if I click in the next page where I would like the only the new formatting that is already there in the document, it would not work. Let me show you. You can see formatting is being applied in the next paragraph or line as well. In order to clear the formatting, you can use just Control and space, and now if I write, you can see formatting has been cleared. Sometime in your document you need to insert a date or time, and for this you need to go to insert, and then you can come over here and then insert date and time. I'm going to show you a pretty easy shortcut for this. You just need to click Alt Shift and D. Here you can see automatically the date has been inserted. And if you want to insert a time, you just need to press Alt Shift and T and time would be inserted. Another very important technique is how to extract text from a picture in Microsoft Word. Let me show you how this can be done. Let me go to Insert, Picture. And on the desktop, I have saved this picture. Let me click over it and insert it into the document. Now I would like to convert this text into editable text. So what I would do, I will open it in a new file. Let me show you. Again, go to Insert, Picture, this device, and let me insert this picture. Now you can go to File and save it as a PDF. Not as a Word, but as a PDF. Save, and I have saved it as a PDF document on Microsoft, on my desktop. Let me delete it and open it again. This was the document. Let me open it with Microsoft Word. Right click, open with Microsoft Word document, click OK, click OK, and here we go. You can see now this text is editable. If you are enjoying the video, please give it a thumbs up. Let's move to the next technique. Sometimes you have to copy your text from different areas of a document, and most of the time what people do, they just select and copy it and then paste it somewhere. Then they will come back and copy another part of the text and paste it wherever they want. Here I'm going to show you a very simple technique. For example, you want to copy these three words. Let's press Ctrl C to select it, and again we want to copy this particular part. Again Ctrl C, and let me select this part as well, Ctrl C. Now let's suppose you are in a document and you want to insert whatever you have copied. So what you would do, you just need to click Window key and V, and here we go. You have been given the options about what you would like to paste, because whatever you have copied has been saved in the clipboard and it can be inserted as and when required without going back and forth in your document. Reading, again press Window key and V, and this time you can insert heading. Again Window key and V, and this time you can insert galleries. I hope you have loved this technique. Sometime in a document you have to insert a line, and what most of the people do, they would go to insert into the shapes and they would select this line and they would insert it like this. And this is really time consuming process. Let me delete it. The easiest way to insert a line in a document is just go to your minus key and press it thrice, 1, 2, 3, and now press enter, and here we go. A line would be inserted automatically into your document. Let's move to the next trick. The next technique is not totally about Microsoft Word, but you can use it in Microsoft Word as well. This is about using Snip and Sketch tool in Microsoft Word. Let me show you a shortcut for this. You can just press Window key, Shift and S on your keyboard, and you can see our Snip and Sketch tool got activated, and we can now use it to cut whatever is present on our screen. It got saved in our clipboard, and you can paste it over here as well as a picture. And if you want to save it as a PNG photo, you just need to click over it and you can click on Save as a Picture, and it will be saved as a picture on your desktop. The next technique that I would like to share with you is how to use Format Painter. For example, you have applied some formatting to this particular text. Let me select it, change its color to red, make it bold, and change its font to, let's say, Calibri Light. And now I want this particular formatting to be applied to another text. So what I would do, I would just select it, click on the Format Painter, and now you can just click and the formatting would be automatically copied to it. In this way, you can apply one kind of formatting to other text in your document. The next technique that I would like to share with you is how to rearrange the words in a proper order. Here you can see I have written some names and I would like these names to be in a proper order. So what I would do, I would just select these words and go to numbering, click, here we go. And if you like to remove the numbering, click again, and here you can see they are in proper order now. Let's move to the next trick. Here you can see we have some names and they are not in alphabetical order. If you want them in alphabetical order, you can use the sort feature in Microsoft Word. First you need to select them, and now you can go to sort feature. Here you can see a down arrow, click over it, and now you can see you can rearrange these names by ascending or descending order. Let me rearrange them by ascending order. So I would click OK, and here you can see now they have been arranged in alphabetical order. Similarly, you can also do the same for dates. If you have some dates, it would be arranged according to the date. So I'm not going to repeat this for you. You can easily do it. The next technique is about selecting something in Microsoft Word document vertically. For example, you want to select something, synthesis, characterized, etc. But you can't do this. As soon as you try to select it, everything in the text is getting selected. So how would you do that? You just need to press Alt and then click inside the document. Here you can see. And now if you click on B, it would get bold, and you can change its formatting to whatever style you want to apply. Let me press Ctrl Z to go back. For example, here you can see I have written some names and I want only the Mr. part to be bold. So what I would do, for example, I would click on Alt and then select only the first part. And now if I click on B, it would get bold. I hope you have learned a lot of things in this particular video. Be sure to subscribe my channel and don't miss the cool tips and tricks on my channel. Thanks for watching.